Previously on Hell's Kitchen.
The one thing that's missing is teamwork.
Chef Ramsay tested the chef's teamwork skills when he opened the restaurant for breakfast.
Are you ready to meet your customer this morning?
For 100 spirited kids.
Seth, why have you slowed down?
Let's go!
Colleen, get the fucking hash browns on.
The women won their first challenge.
Damn it!
Which resulted in a power struggle on the men's team.
I am obviously the best cook on the team.
You couldn't cook my cock.
Ben, at dinner service.
I've had up to here.
Both Ben.
How can someone so fat say something so fucking thin?
And Danny.
Where's the fucking mashed potato?
Had their problems.
30 seconds, I'm gonna fucking kick you out personally.
But they were not alone.
Are you fucking stupid?
No, chef.
Jay's salad was a disaster.
Look what's in my salad.
And Seth was a mess.
Hey, Bozo, I just watched you wipe your face and then wipe a pan.
Fuck.
In the red kitchen, Colleen hit a new low.
Where's the Wellington, please? 3 Wellingtons, you brought me 4.
I don't know, chef.
You
I'll take
don't
it back.
Know.
Her brain, and it's just breaking down.
It was the worst dinner service yet.
You're all shit. No one's won. Get out!
Both teams were ordered to nominate 2 of their own.
You think I'm the one on the chopping block, Giovanni? Are you fucking serious?
I'll agree with Gio.
There's no fucking way.
But even though Chef Ramsay had 4 chefs to choose from...
Lacey, Colleen, Ben, Seth, step forward.
He wasted little time in making his decision.
Seth, take your jacket off. I can't go any further with you, big boy.
And with that, Seth's dream of becoming head chef at Borgata Hotel in Atlantic City was finished. But Chef Ramsay wasn't.
Lacey.
Yes, chef?
You're now on the men's team.
And the bitches rejoice.
Now, the continuation of Hell's Kitchen.
Dude, we're winning everything.
Lacey is the Blues Brothers problem now. The kitchen gods have answered my prayers.
Bitch, get the fuck over here.
I'm sorry, I can't contain myself.
Well, ladies, you're free of me. Welcome your new team member, please.
Welcome, Lacey.
All right, Lacey, come over here and sit
Thank
down.
Thank you.
Whatever. You guys just lost your best fucking player.
Yeah, we did. You guys hate me already, too?
No. Chef Ramsay throws us a curveball. Give us Lacey. Why would he eliminate our shit and then give us the other team's shit?
I think I can speak for all of us. The blue team's not looking for another Seth. We were just on the verge of losing our last piece of dead weight. We feel there's a chance that we may have just got another piece.
No, I understand. All I ask is that you give me a chance. If I really suck, please put me up for elimination.
We won't hesitate.
Yeah, we won't.
I know you won't.
Let me just tell you, we're gonna help you the best we can. Our strategy is just to, you know, be the big brother type. But inside of me, I'm saying, Lacey, it's a cancer. There's no time for none of this fucking crying.
That all was personal. Those bitches made me feel like shit every damn day.
And I'll tell you what, you had a saving grace tonight. You better fucking prove yourself.
We lost one of our best team members. Do you think you deserve to be here?
Yeah, getting yelled at again. I was just so sick of the drama on the red team. So tomorrow's a new day, a clean slate. So I hope it all goes well.
They're going down.
Even though Lacey has barely settled into her new team.
You guys ready to roll? Let's go downstairs.
Chef Ramsay has the chefs on the road early.
We're in an Asian market. It was very exciting. I shop in Asian markets all the time. I've got a good idea of all the different ingredients. I mean, not all of them, of course. I can't read it.
Good morning.
Good morning, chef.
So today's challenge is Asian fusion.
Yes, chef.
And when I say fusion, I mean combining cuisines to make exciting, vibrant dishes.
Yes, chef. Yes, chef.
Personally, I love fusion. That's how I get down. I'll make a gourmet meal out of Captain Crunch and frickin' filet mignon. I don't give a shit.
Each team will select one poultry, one seafood, and one meat dish with a strong Asian influence. Is that clear?
Yes, chef.
You'll have 25 minutes to run around this phenomenal Asian market and purchase all the ingredients you'll need for your three dishes. Each team has only $100 to spend, so use your time and money wisely. Are you ready?
Yes, chef.
On your mark, get set, go.
Grab that cart wheel this way.
This way, come.
This Asian fusion challenge will test the chef's creativity and their ability to innovate.
Ladies, we need a plan menu.
10 feet.
The teams have just 25 minutes and $100 to find the ingredients they need to create three Asian fusion dishes.
Listen, I have my entree ready to go. We need to get some rice, crushed red pepper, soy sauce. I'm a force to be reckoned with. I have a loud voice and I have loud thoughts. We need mirin. We need
mirin.
Listen, I'm saying mirin.
Andrea likes to think that she's the leader because she talks the most, but loud and vocal doesn't always make a good leader.
Let's go, guys.
While the red team is stopped to organize, the blue team takes a slightly different approach.
I'm just grabbing shit, man. We'll put stuff back. That's fine.
Let's grab it, let's use it. Come on, let's get the show on the road.
We just like ran around like crazy people, piecing our dish together as we ran through the store.
Some produce rice, dairy, something, ginger, noodles.
That's 320.
No, I want a one that looks good, like this one.
Andrea's yelling at orders, telling us what to do. Seriously, just shut the fuck up.
Oh, hold on, back up.
While Andrea continues to make herself heard on the red team, all Lacey wants to have on her team is a voice.
What are we gonna get for the beef, guys? Guys.
No response. It's the same shit on the blue team that it was on the red team.
Grab the ribeye, get in the cart. Come on, let's go.
Lacey, she's the new guy. There's no way other members of the team are gonna take her seriously.
Let's move along, guys. Let's get this some fish roe.
Andale.
Armed with what they hope will be the key ingredients, both teams make it to the checkout in time.
95, 97.
And on budget. Now, each team will have 1 hour to complete three dishes. Chef Ramsay has instructed the teams to work in pairs.
All right.
I don't do Asian a lot, so just...
That's all right.
I took Lacey under my wing. I personally will kick her in the ass if I think she needs it.
Lacey, this is how I set up my station. Fold my towel in half. You're gonna work next to me. Try and do the same.
I think Ben just likes to talk to hear the sound of his own voice.
Just it's more when I see.
Aye, Captain.
Give me a couple taps on this. Just tap me with anything, that spoon or...
Yeah, we're confident. We know what we're doing.
Yes, son.
Just thinking like that.
Dude, beautiful.
Let's call it Fat Man Slim's Asian barbecue, son.
The blue team pairs are feeling confident. Meanwhile, the red team duos...
I don't understand what we're doing, but I'll just listen to you.
...are still finding their way.
Andrea, what other dishes? Quickly run through.
Right now, we're working on tuna wrapped in seaweed.
Asian fusion. I don't want it boring. Yes?
Yes, chef.
Okay, that's gonna be a problem with this tuna dish. I had to rethink my dish a little bit because I was kind of going all Asian, you know, with no fusion in there.
So we're going Japanese French.
Yeah, aioli's French, but it's Asian flavors.
Just make it a lemon aioli.
While the entire red team pitches in on Paula's tuna dish, over in the blue kitchen, Lacey is just trying to make a contribution.
Jay, do you need help?
I'm good right now.
Anybody need anything? I'm not needed at all. I was basically doing bullshit jobs. Like, oh, slice this, dice that, you know. Anyone can cut an onion. Come on, guys, what can I do?
Nothing.
Last minute, let's go. That means plated, clean, ready to go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and stop. Happy?
Yes, chef.
Winning this challenge is very, very important to us. We're coming off some losses, so we gotta show up big time.
I'd like you all to meet somebody. Someone that will help me judge. This lady, editor-in-chief of the award-winning Epicurious.com. Please meet Tanya Steel. Let's go.
Everybody out there who cooks knows Epicurious.com. I was so psyched. Who doesn't know who that is?
But whatever the hell she's from, that's why I came and pronounced it. I don't know who this lady was. She was attractive, but I don't know who she is.
Now, the winning team today, all of those dishes is going to be heavily featured on the Epicurious.com website. Okay, now, First dish, poultry. Let's go.
First up, it's Carol and Coy versus Robert and Danny.
This is a pomegranate cinnamon glazed chicken breast.
Now, why'd you choose pomegranate?
I love pomegranate. It's a nice fruity fruit.
Presentation looks slightly boring.
And it's a little bit dry. But I like the flavors.
Yes. Okay, Robert, describe your dish, please.
It's a traditional pad thai, but the chicken is prepared like barbecue chicken on a Sunday afternoon.
Chef Ramsay tasted my dish, one of the greatest culinary minds of the 21st century, and you're sitting there like, here's my dish, I hope you like it.
This is kind of a confluence of Southern and Asian,
yes,
for you,
exactly.
Essentially.
Seasoning, nice. Which one would you go for?
I would definitely go for this one.
I totally agree. Well done.
Thank you.
Back in line. Men, 1-0.
Nice job, Robert. Nice job, brother.
Robert and I definitely rocked the house today. We fucking nailed it.
Next up, it's Paula and L.A. against Ben and Lacey.
Okay, Paula.
Okay, Chef, we did a tuna tempura, very simple. We did the vegetables, all confit styles, and we made an aioli.
Paula's dish simply didn't see the fusion in it. It really looked like a pile of steamed mushroom.
Wow, temperature in the tuna is extraordinary.
Mm. And this is just perfectly cooked.
It really is perfectly cooked.
Thank you, Chef.
This is...
We have pan-seared scallop. Mm-hmm. The sauce is, it's actually a sea urchin and caviar beurre blanc.
Very dangerous to combine caviar and sea urchin together.
Yes.
If people were to ask me, what's your specialty, Ben, I would probably say it's French-Asian fusion.
Slightly salty for me.
Yeah.
It's a little bit mushy.
If I had to choose, I would go with that one.
I'm gonna choose the tuna also.
Thank you.
Okay, good.
I'm so glad we all got together.
With the score tied, Jay and Giovanni will now face off against Colleen and Andrea.
Being the tiebreaker of all things is just, oh, I can't even tell you.
Okay, Andrea, you go first.
Today we have a Kobe beef sashimi brushed with a Korean style sauce.
When you say Korean sauce, what's in there?
We have soy sauce, some sugar,
and a lot of red pepper flakes.
Mm. Yeah. My mouth is really
ouch.
Yeah.
That's clumsy seasoning. It's a shame, because the beef's delicious.
Mm-hmm. I think the beef really saves this dish.
Jay.
Yes, Chef. We have a beef.
You don't know what it is? Dear, oh dear.
What is it?
It's a beef pizzaiola style.
Pizzaiola style? I forgot what the hell Giovanni wanted to call it. Beef pistachio.
Crunchy bits of rice, granules in my teeth. I undercooked. Love the idea. However, there's no excuse for undercooked rice. Okay, which one?
This is one we're gonna have to debate.
Yeah? Back in line? Okay, Tanya, I'm gonna leave this one to you because it's going on your website.
Mm.
Which one would you go for?
I'm gonna have to go with my ladies.
The ladies stick together, man. No matter who the lady is, y'all are brotherhood, sisterhood, some shit.
Thank you.
Right, ladies, your reward. You've got a day packed with surprises with a big Asian influence.
I don't know exactly what that means. I'll take it. Bring it on.
Well done. Yes? Gentlemen.
Yes, Chef.
And Lacey. Your first part of the punishment will be preparing homemade fortune cookie.
I never made fortune cookies in my life. I've eaten a damn shitload of them.
So damn difficult, you've got no idea. Secondly, we'll be decorating the whole restaurant with origami.
I'm sick of these punishments. I can't win challenges. I'm sick of losing.
Go get change, your limo's waiting for you. Hurry up, let's go.
I can't do this anymore. I'm about to really go fucking crazy.
Dear, oh dear.
I'm gonna go home.
Stop saying that.
Giovanni!
There's no one going home because we don't plan on fucking losing. So stop saying you're going home.
You guys are never gonna understand what it's like to be in a room where 11 other people hate you and don't want you here.
It's hard to get along with her. For a lot of people, the boys are just as frustrated as the girls were.
As much as Seth sucked, never once did he say he was going home.
I don't care.
what frustrates me the most is negativity. We don't want to lose. We don't want to send anybody from the blue team home.
I don't deserve everybody.
Personal standpoint, have I ever treated you like shit?
No.
Okay. Be a little more motivated to have a sense of urgency in some of the things that you do.
I will help anyone in the kitchen who needs my help. That's just how I am. That's what a chef does.
We need you.
I know, but I don't understand. I'm
on,
not
Lacey,
usually
what I'm
like this.
We need you. And if that's any indication, don't give up.
Ben is trying to blow smoke up my ass. Whatever. In the end, everyone's in it for themselves.
Whatever I can do to help you get more involved with what we're doing to help us move forward, just ask.
While Ben tries to convince Lacey that the blue team is better off with her, the red team is convinced that they're better off without her.
What can I do? What can I do? I am thrilled that Lacey is not on the red team.
We lost a lot of weight.
Talking about Lacey, okay, that's enough. The fact remains, we're in this limo now, and they're back there doing fortune cookies.
There's a hair in the fortune cookie!
Shut up.
Bloody hell, that's hot.
Please kill me now. I don't understand the purpose of putting this broad over here.
Fly away, little crane.
Her voice feels like a tack hammer in the eye, man.
I love it.
I don't like her, man.
You guys are way more fun than the girls.
Welcome, welcome.
Thank you. Yeah. I thought we were gonna, you know, learn how to, like, defend ourselves. If Chef Ramsay comes at us, you know, we can just, like, karate kick his saute pans away.
Today, you are going to learn a martial art. I'm going to bring out our first Rikishi. He is an expert in the art of discipline. We have arranged for another pupil. He is the Belgian ninja.
The other sumo wrestler was Jean-Philippe. He looked like somebody just got done, like, torturing him. Immaculate Jean-Philippe is stuffed into this sumo outfit, just looking pissed off.
Fight!
He was just tossing him around like it was yesterday's salad.
This didn't seem fair, big old Chef Ramsay against little old Jean-Philippe.
Surrender!
Chef Ramsay kicked his ass.
I won! Oh, my God.
Then we all got to put on the suits. Little Carol looked adorable.
I really think I need a child size.
I'm the biggest, she's the smallest. But she's like, I'll take you. I was like, well, come on then.
Let's go. Oh. Push each other, don't kiss each other. Push! That's it, Carol, yes! Oh!
I couldn't wait to get in there. I wanted to take the biggest, baddest bitch in there on.
Watch my lip ring, please.
Lip ring. Let's go. Uh-oh! Let's go! Have a great day. Yes, well done, ladies. Yes, well done.
While the women battle it out, back in Hell's Kitchen, the blue team has conquered fortune cookies and is now wrestling with origami.
I love how the directions say, at first, it will seem impossible.
This is going to piss me off to no avail.
Wait, how come one of my creases is in and one is in both of yours are out?
In your face, I'm done. Yatch!
All right, well, apparently we got to watch her.
Yeah, dude.
Let's watch Lacey.
Oh, Lacey.
And let's watch her.
Ladies, come, come. Please sit down. We're going to enjoy and learn about sake today. So here we go. As in the Japanese say, kanpai.
Kanpai.
Oh, it's so good.
Yes,
my goodness.
I have a new favorite drink.
I need about 10 of those.
I think I did about 9 sake shots.
We're going to be drunk.
I can't remember.
While the red team celebrates their good fortune, back at Hell's Kitchen, one chef's fortunes are looking up as well.
You fold this up, and you pull this out and make a head. And there you go. Did that help?
Yeah, it did.
It was nice to know that finally I could teach someone something. That made me feel really good and needed.
It only took origami to bring us together.
I believe Lacey did a great job teaching us how to do the origami, and it was much easier with her on a team, and we worked as a team, and she turned it around for us.
We're united in this origami madness.
Fire! Fire!
You smell the sake on my breath? Whoa, I went the wrong way.
Trust me, one of those bitches is going home tomorrow.
Fuck it.
Both teams have clearly bonded over the last 24 hours.
What do you think, partner? Work together?
Hell yeah.
And are more determined than ever to beat their opponents.
You guys miss Lacey.
What kind of question is that?
We've decided that she doesn't exist.
Who's Lacey?
I hate to be mean, you know, but the blue team is just gonna get a taste of what we've had to go through with Lacey, and they're gonna have a rude awakening.
Oh, my arm's about to fall the hell off.
With dinner service just minutes away, the teams hurry to finish prep.
I'll help in any way I can.
I'll get it. You go ahead, keep doing what you're doing.
Let's help each other out.
All right, guys, come over quick. Bobby, let's go. Lacey, how are you settling down with the men?
Good, Chef.
Yeah, who's mentoring you?
Right now, Ben's helping me out a lot, Chef, but nice. All the guys are helping me out.
Nice, nice. Okay, Paula.
Yeah, Chef.
In all the Hell's Kitchens, that tuna dish, quite frankly, is one of the best dishes I've ever seen in here.
Thank you, Chef.
Tuna's extraordinary.
It's perfectly cooked.
It really is perfectly cooked.
Thank you, Chef.
It's on the menu tonight, yeah?
Yes,
really,
Chef.
Well done.
Thank you, Chef.
Last service, we went 3 feet back, yes? Tonight, we come forward, yes?
Yes, Chef.
Okay, move your ass, let's go. Jean-Philippe, open Hell's Kitchen, please.
With the previous dinner service being one of their worst, the chefs are determined to make this comeback night.
All right, Blues Brothers, let's roll. On order, 3 couples table, 53, yes? One scallops, one spaghetti, one risotto, entree, one tuna, one salmon, one lamb. Wake up, yes?
You'll see that the ahi tuna is actually on the menu tonight.
In the Blue Kitchen, the pressure's on Giovanni on the appetizer station to get the first order off to a good start.
Risotto, please, let's go. Stop working in midair, Giovanni. It looks so stupid like this in midair all day. Come on, Bozo. Giovanni.
Yes, Chef.
Very nice, that risotto. They stay like that all night. Yes,
yes, Chef. Get the hell out of here.
Nice job, sir.
While Giovanni enjoys a rare compliment from Chef Ramsay, over in the Red Kitchen, L.A. is hoping to impress with her appetizers.
Whoa! L.A., very nice, that risotto.
Thank you, Chef.
Getting compliments from Chef Ramsay, that's like my dad telling me he's proud of me, you know what I mean? Doesn't get any better than that.
The risotto's coming out tonight. Delicious, huh?
It's 30 minutes into dinner service, and appetizers are flying out of both kitchens. But the customers with the biggest appetites have just arrived.
I would like the entire menu, please.
One of everything?
Yeah, the whole thing. Entire menu for each of us.
Yes?
Absolutely. I'm fine. Bye. Bye. I'm sorry, but there's two guests on there. It looks like a table of six or eight.
I know, Chef, there are sumo wrestlers.
Sumo wrestlers.
With such a heavy load this early in dinner service, Chef Ramsay decides to split the large order between the kitchens.
Watch this table. One soup, one Caesar, one scallop, risotto, one spaghetti. Yes?
Yes, Chef!
Let's go. On order, 2 covers, table 23. 2 sumo wrestlers, 1 soup, 1 Caesar, 1 scallop, 1 risotto, 1 spaghetti. I know there's only 2 of them there, but they eat like fucking horses. Let's go.
Yes, Chef.
While both teams scramble to get the large orders started, back in the Blue Kitchen, a leader is emerging.
Guys, I'm going in like a minute and a half, all right?
Yep, let's do it.
Come on, guys.
Lacey was throwing her food up. She was very vocal, asking people how long on this.
Jay, how long?
And how long on that?
Chicken 2 Wellington, where you at?
Maybe she's motivated that she wants to kick the red team's ass.
Doing a great job, man. Keep it together.
Keep going, Lacey. Keep
Come
going.
On. Robert, how you looking on the tuna, baby?
About to drop it.
All right, hold on. Robert needs some time. Really trying to make it a great service because I don't want to go home. Come on, guys.
It's 50 minutes into dinner service, and while the oversized diners don't keep their opinions a secret...
Oh, the scallops are great. How did you like it?
Same as you.
Very good.
In the Red Kitchen, Andrea has a little secret of her own.
LA, you ready with those apps?
I fired Wellingtons. I realized that they were burnt.
Where's the scallops?
And there was no way I was going to take a burnt bottom Wellington up to the pass.
Koi, 2 lambs, 2 Wellington. I'm at least 8 minutes out, okay? Still 8 minutes?
Yes, it's going to get done, okay?
While Andrea hides her Wellingtons, it's now time for Jay to deliver his.
Tuna Dory to Wellington, yes?
Yes, Chef.
Yes, Chef. Jay.
It's gonna be a couple minutes on the Wellingtons. They're still fucking rare. When I cut into that first Wellington and it was raw fucking cold, my heart fucking stopped.
What happened to the Wellingtons?
Sir, I don't know. I fired them the same as last time.
Fan's on low, it should be on high.
Why is the fan down low?
I'm sorry, Chef.
I'm glad you're so fucking laid back about it.
I should have fucking looked at the oven. It just sucks that I look like a goddamn donkey.
If the Wellingtons aren't ready, don't drop the dory. You're just in a little world of your own. I need a team effort.
Yes, Chef. Sorry, guys.
While Jay tries to follow directions, over in the Red Kitchen, Chef Ramsay has found a problem.
Look at the oven. Have we got Wellingtons in there?
Yes, Chef.
Hey, madam. Come here, you. Right now. What happens when the door's wide open?
The oven gets cold, Chef.
Okay, what else is in there?
A Wellington, Chef. I was not leaving the oven door open. I don't think I did. But I could have.
Where's the Wellington, please?
Chef, I'm refiring a Wellington. The bottom's burning.
Where's the medium well Wellington?
I'm putting protective paper.
Shut up, you, yeah? Shut up. What is this?
They burn. I'm not quite sure
Watch.
Why.
Watch, look. Hey, come here. Oi. There you go. Oh, dear. Fucking pile of shit.
I'm screwed. I'm fucking screwed.
Anything else, Where else have you
No, Chef, that's it, Chef.
That's it, Chef. What are you doing?
Trying to get it together, Chef.
I don't understand it.
While the red team waits for Andrea to cook more Wellingtons, over in the blue kitchen, Chef Ramsay is waiting for...
Bobby, let's go. Let's go, Bobby. I'm saying it once. Move, Bobby, yeah? You could do with losing a few pounds. Let's go.
Fucking asshole.
First of all, my name is not Bobby. It's Robert. So when he says Bobby, who the fuck is that?
Bobby! No answer.
My father's name's Bobby, and I had a fucked up childhood.
Bobby, look at me.
Every time I hear that, it brings you back. So he touched a nerve with me.
Bobby, Dory, Tuna, where is it? Why is he throwing stuff in the bin?
Because...
Fuck me.
Here it comes.
What's going on? All this food in here. How much are you throwing away?
Too much, Chef.
You can't just trash it like that.
I was thinking you wouldn't take it, put it up there when we put...
Whatever. Say that again, please?
No, I can't.
Why can't you look at me when I talk to you?
Sorry, Chef. Sorry, Chef.
Robert! Come here, you. Fucker. Get out! Get out! Get in there! What are you doing?
I'm trying to do the best I can for you.
Why is it so... Fuck me! It's not about me. It's about you.
I refuse to put anything up there that you're going to send back, Chef.
Listen to me. Concentrate. Stop picking on me as an excuse. That's not good enough. You can't trash all that.
I fucked up, and I'm not going to put it up to you.
Wake up, Robert!
Dude, it took a lot for me to fucking hold back, son. I'll tell you that.
Hey, have you given up?
Fuck no, Chef.
Hey, I'm not doing that to you, Chef. It's going in the trash can again.
I ain't trying to make him proud of me anymore. Chef Ramsay, kiss my ass. That's what I'm saying to him.
Hey. If you've got any comeback, I'd do it now if I was you. Yeah, because you look like one sulky, pissed off cook. Find some form of passion. Cook your heart out. Stop fucking around.
Yes, Chef.
Robert's waste has put him a little behind in his work, but he's not the only one.
Tuna, Dory, salmon, chicken, lamb, Wellington, how long?
We're about 4 minutes out, Chef.
Why still 4 minutes? Is it coming in 4 minutes?
Is it really coming?
What is going on?
I'm trying to get it together, Chef.
My times were off, my fucking calls were off, my communication was off, my cooking skills were off. It was bad.
Is it 4 minutes? Please tell me, Andrea.
But sweetie, I already told you I'm about 6 minutes out.
She would just throw out a number off the top of her head. Where that number was coming from, I don't have any idea.
How long?
Chef, I'm about 2 minutes out.
Are you 2 minutes out? You told me you wouldn't leave me in the dark on the John Dory.
Andrea, come here, you.
Yes, Chef.
What are you doing?
I'm fucking up, Chef.
You're fucking up big time.
Yes, Chef.
And I'm getting really pissed off because nothing's happening.
Yes, Chef.
Now, can you work as a team?
Yes, Chef.
It's more than 2 hours into dinner service. And with both kitchens at a near standstill, diners are growing restless.
We're missing something, right?
What?
We're still missing more plates.
It should be here shortly.
It's not a pretty picture now.
With the pressure mounting to get some food out to the customers, Chef Ramsay turns to...
Jay! The chicken's raw! Jay!
Yes, sir.
No entrees has left this kitchen in nearly 14 minutes. Nothing. 14 minutes, nothing's gone out.
I fucked up everything. Everything. Every goddamn thing.
Do you want to go home?
No, Chef. Yeah.
Get a grip!
Yes, Chef.
Get a grip!
Yes, Chef.
Jay, can I go to the pass, yes or no?
Can we go?
What do you need?
Lamb.
He's asking you now what he needs. He doesn't even know.
Come on, guys. How long on that lamb?
Oh, Jay. You forgot it, yes?
Yes, Chef.
Communicate!
Yes, Chef.
Yes, Chef.
Oh, my God.
I know Jay was having a really bad night, but he, like, forgot an order.
Hey, look at me. Hey, you are shit.
Jay takes a moment for a little self-reflection.
Dessert.
Meanwhile, despite numerous problems, the Red Kitchen has managed to move on to desserts.
It's absolutely rock hard.
That's a rock solid. Let me bring it back.
Thank you, Jean.
Red 53, Tanya Steel.
Not done. There you go. Yeah, I've had enough. I've had enough. Come here. There you go. Take a bite and pass it along. LA, wake up, yeah?
Pass
yeah,
come here.
Raw pastry, raw pear. That's her.
Chef Ramsay wasn't kidding when he said it was raw. It was raw. That's just sorry, poor judgment.
You didn't know that's raw pastry with a raw pear?
No, Chef.
Everybody else is just looking around like, you've got to be kidding me.
Unfucking believable.
Tonight, dinner service has totally collapsed.
Christ almighty. 2.5 hours of bullshit.
And Chef Ramsay is at the end of his rope.
Oh, fuck off. I've had enough. Hey, when I say I've had enough, I've had enough. Stove's off. Come here. That was pathetic. And you were absolutely useless. Clear down. I can't take it anymore. It's been the worst performance so far. Switch it fucking off.
After a promising beginning, dinner service has ended in disaster. And Chef Ramsay has a question for one of the chefs.
Robert.
Yes, Chef.
Why don't you look at me when I talk to you?
That's something I like to speak to you in private before a chef.
Later. Right now, I don't need any private bullshit from anybody. The meat section in the blue kitchen and the red kitchen was horrific. It's impossible to announce a winning team. Giovanni.
Yes, Chef.
LA.
Yes, Chef.
Good work tonight.
Thank you,
yes,
Chef.
Really well done.
Thank you, Chef.
On the back of that performance, nominate one individual from the blue team and nominate one individual from the ladies for elimination.
Yes, Chef.
Piss off.
You know what he calls me all the time?
Bobby.
He calls me Bobby. My name's Robert. My father was like a real, his name was Bobby, and was like...
So when he calls you Bobby, you don't
like,
hook up?
I look at him, it's like another male figure in your life that you're supposed to respect that treats you like shit. I know he had the same kind of childhood.
Hello?
Would you please send Bobby to my office?
Thank you.
Come in.
Hello, Chef.
Hello, Bobby. Okay. You wanted to see me.
The main thing is, like, I know you don't understand, and that's why I'm telling you, like, my name is Robert, not Bobby. Once that's my father's name, and, like, growing up, it's been a hard road for me. I've been told all my life that you're a loser, you're a quitter, and
right.
His name was Bobby, and the moments that when I'm called that, and then you're like, look me in my eye, just that one precise second, it was just like flashback all okay. Back, you know, so.
That's fair enough. I get that, yeah. I take that, and I totally respect that. I apologize if it's upset you by calling you Bobby. Just, I wish you had brought that to my attention earlier, because I wouldn't have done it. However, it's off your chest. Totally respect that, and I will totally follow it through.
Thank you, Chef.
Okay?
appreciate the time, officer.
Not at all.
The way I cooked tonight was fucked up.
It's safe to say that Andrew and Colleen are the two on my list to go up.
LA, I'm telling you right now, if I'm nominated, I totally understand, and I do not hold that against you on any level.
Andrew was definitely behind today, and she just got overwhelmed, but she's a good chef.
I believe if one of us goes up there, that they'll send the blue team home. I'm okay with that.
Colleen's consistent. I mean, she's consistently fucked up on every service.
It's your decision.
Fucked up bad. Fucked up real bad.
I've never cooked that bad in my life. It's a fucking disgrace. Who knows what's gonna happen? Giovanni's gonna make his own decision, and I could be going home.
You do what you gotta do, man. Who you pick?
I can't pick her. She kicked ass. I can't pick her.
I did well, and now my reward is this. I have to pick one of my own teammates to leave.
So you pick me?
It's a toss-up between me and Jay, but I just hope that Giovanni looks at the bigger picture.
I made my decision.
What a tough night. LA, have you made your decision?
Yes, Chef.
Who is it?
Andrea.
Andrea?
Yes, Chef.
Why?
Her communication wasn't there. The cooking wasn't there. It wasn't there.
Giovanni, have you made your decision?
Yes, Chef. I picked Jake. He performed bad from the start to the end.
Who else was there?
Robert.
Why?
He started out bad, but was able to recuperate and come out of it a little bit better than Jay was.
Maybe just a fraction.
And that fraction saved him.
Does it? Okay, Jay, Andrew, step forward. Okay. Right, Jay, why do you think you should stay in Hell's Kitchen?
Well, I've got the skills and I have the talent. I'm very confident. I know what I'm able to do, and...
You lost it tonight. You didn't even get started.
There's no excuse. This is definitely my worst performance in my career.
You're not wrong there. So the other horrendous performance on the meat was you, Andrea?
Yes, Chef.
I mean, why should you stay?
I want to stay in Hell's Kitchen because I want the opportunity to be back on that meat station, and I want to nail it from beginning to end and prove that I have what it takes, not only to you, but to myself, Chef.
This is a tough one. This is really tough for me.
What do you need?
Lamb.
Oh, Jay. You forgot it, yes?
Yes, Chef.
What is this?
They burn, I'm not quite sure why.
What are you doing?
Pile of shit.
The person leaving Hell's Kitchen tonight is... Jay.
Yes, Chef.
Andrea. Back in line. Okay, Robert. Wake up.
Yes, Chef.
Colleen, here.
Yes, Chef.
You've had 5 services, madam, and all 5 of them have been shocking. Take off your jacket and leave Hell's Kitchen.
Yes, Chef.
But I will say something. I love your tenacity.
Thank you, Chef.
You are strong.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Chef Ramsay and Hell's Kitchen made me better. It made me a better person, it's gonna make me a better mom, it's gonna make me a better chef, and it's gonna make me a better instructor. And I hope that one day he'll cook at my cooking school.
There's one quality that girl has that a lot of you haven't got, and that's fight. And that's what I want to see, a fight to make up for your mistakes and to come back strong. Good night.
I feel like I've been in a big-ass fight with a heavyweight, and I ain't been beaten, but I sure got beat up.
All chefs have bad nights, but I know I can win Hell's Kitchen. My gloves are off, and I'm in this to win.
Looks like I get another shot, so I'm not gonna mess up again, that's for sure.
There was no place in the kitchen I could put Colleen where she wasn't a disaster. It's time for her to go back to where she belongs, teaching, because she certainly can't cook.
Next time,
we are open for a bar mitzvah.
It's a Hell's Kitchen first.
This is my time to shine. We're cooking for my people.
But the celebration...
Don't drop it!
...comes crashing down.
Oh!
No way. Oh, shit! Oh, my God!
And that's just the beginning of a disastrous dinner service.
Jay!
Slip out of it!
Why is no one talking to each other?
The chefs are at each other's throats.
You got the fries?
They're not ready!
I asked
it! I didn't see it getting done.
Stop!
I'm ready to just sew her fucking lips closed.
You know what, Carol? Fuck you!
All for a chance to become head chef at Borgata Atlantic City.
Nah! Can we work together as a team?
Even the dining room is a danger zone.
I just had enough of you.
No way.
It's anything but kosher.
Fuck!
On a very special edition of Hell's Kitchen.